Hello and welcome to another update video about the S&P 500 as we are heading here into the weekend. It was an interesting week last week as well. I think we currently have a chance here that we are heading down in wave two. I think when I made my last video, we might have just hit resistance here. I'm not entirely sure, but I did keep you updated here in my last video about a possible completion of this five wave move to the upside. It is a diagonal pattern at best, so it's not an impulse. What we see here on the S&P 500 chart off the low, which was here around 3500, so the S&P did reverse in my support area, came up, moved up in a wave 1, 2, then here the wave 3, down in a 4, hit the channel support, and then we can count 5 waves up. So very clear diagonal pattern in the fifth wave of one. Problem with these diagonals is always it can easily also be a corrective wave. So this could purely just be a correction. We come down and more impulsively as well. So we need to be on the lookout here. The retracement now needs to hold certain levels. I think we could be exhausted to the upside here. I posted that on Telegram and Discord already a few days ago. I think when we had hit the channel resistance here, that we could be coming down. We then moved down from 4,000 to around about 3,900 in what I believe was a wave A of two. I think we are now moving up in a nice three wave move in a wave B and would then come down in a wave C possibly next week. Target for that wave C. So it basically indicates that we have a chance or first signal for a trend reversal on the S&P 500. That this wave four low has been in. It's the very first signal. It's nothing convincing yet. What we wanna see is that the wave two support box is holding. And then to get really confirmation is the next move up and a break above the wave one high here at around 4,050. That would be a really good confirmation that a low is in. Until then, things are not really confirmed. And the problem with that is because of this five wave move, which is a diagonal pattern, they're not super reliable. But of course, you know, we can go with that at the moment as we can count five valid waves up. So yeah, wave A done of the wave two, then the wave B and the wave C should come next. Do we already know that wave B is finished? Well, we don't know it, but we have a three wave structure complete. So that is always an indication that things could be turning to the downside again. And if we draw the fibs, we see that we reached sort of the 61.8% fib level in a wave B. That's absolutely fine. And I think we're now ready to move down in C. The wave C is a five wave move. So it could very well be that this was 1, 2, next would be 3, move up in 4 and come down in 5. Yeah, this is sort of a very valid scenario. Should we move higher and break above that $4,017 level, then it would get, in my opinion, more likely that we haven't actually finished this uptrend yet and that we're going to see more highs. I mean, at least this is a sort of first signal. I think a really good indication would be a breakout above that previous high of 4,050. But until that happens, primarily, I would expect now downside in this wave two. This wave two support box is located between 3,840 and 3,700, which is the 61.8% fib level. Now I would even allow this wave two to go, of course, into the 78.6% fib level. I haven't added it to this chart, and the reason for that is because there is a lot of support going to be here due to the channel support trend line. Yeah, and it would be a very long wave C as well if we really come down to that level, but we can't rule it out. What I'll do, if we drop below the $3,700 level, then it would still be a valid 1-2. In fact, it would still be okay and likely that it's holding. It's just that the target box then was not in the correct position. But please understand that a wave 2 can go down easily to the 78.6% fib level. But for me, at the moment, it looks like this would be a very long distance. And also, we've got the channel. Now, we can talk about that as soon as we've broken the channel to the downside. But what you need to understand is that this move down now is a stress test for the bullish scenario. It's not going to be guaranteed that the support is holding. That's what the market will decide. But this is the area where ideally we're turning around and move up in the third wave. Okay, and that's my update about the S&P 500. I hope you liked the update. If you did, please hit the like button, leave a comment and subscribe. And if you really like the content, then please check out the channel membership. Thanks a lot for watching. Bye-bye.